फ्रेंड्स
कॉन्फ्रेंस चालू।
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हेलो सर, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई कॉल अपन सेशन वन पार्टिसिपेंट दैट इज अनायतुल्ला वानी। द पेपर नेम इज इफेक्ट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन मीडिया ऑन स्कॉलरस्टिक अचीवमेंट इन प्राइमरी स्कूल्स इन काश्मीर एंड द पेपर आईडी इज ICPRAM09. Welcome, sir. Welcome, ma'am. And you can share your PPTs. Hello? Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Go ahead.
Yes, sir. The first participant is Anaitullah Wani. The paper is Effect of Information Media on Scholastic Achievement in Primary Schools in Kashmir. And the paper ID is ICPRAM09. Over to Wani. You can share your PPTs. Hello, Anaitullah Wani. Hello. Hello. Okay. We call upon the next paper by Ramesh V. The paper name is A New Approach to the Technique of Selfish Node Detection Based on Modified Skellum Distribution in MANETs. And the paper ID is ICPRAM10.
Hello.
Yes, sir. You can share your PPTs.
It's audible?
Yeah. Yeah, sir. Please continue.
Okay. A very good afternoon to everyone present here. I am Ramesh V, a research scholar, Border University, Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. I am doing my research with the guidance of Dr. C. Suresh Kumar, Principal, Dr. Nagaratnam College of Engineering, Tamil Nadu. I am going to present my research paper in the title, A New Approach to the Technique of Selfish Node Detection Based on Modified Skellum Distribution in MANETs. First, I start my abstract of my research paper is, in mobile ad hoc networks, nodes depends on each other for routing and forwarding packets. Cooperation among nodes is a key issue in such an environment. However, some of the nodes in MANETs may behave selfishly and may not forward packets to save battery and other resources. Since nodes in MANET communicate on a peer-to-peer basis without any central authority, which can monitor selfish behavior of nodes, a centralized solution to the stimulate cooperation is not stable. Nowadays, selfish node is a huge problem in MANET. In MANET, every node forwards the data packets to neighboring nodes and use up its battery power, bandwidth, and memory space. All the nodes transmit packets to other nodes according to their necessities in ideal security. Presence of selfish node in the network creates data communication failure.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, tell me. Madam.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, tell
me.
Sir,
we request other participants to mute their voice. Others, please mute your voice. It's disturbing a lot. Thank you. Sir, you can continue.
Okay, thank you, madam. In MANET, every node forwards the data packets to neighboring nodes and use up its battery power, bandwidth, and memory space. All the nodes transmit packets to other nodes according to their necessities in the ideal situation. Presence of selfish node in the network creates data communication failure and node does not transmit packets and utilize the network resources for its own profit but it refuses to share their personal results for other nodes. Due to presence of selfish node in the network is defective and the data communication between nodes is disturbed. It is an important issue to timely detect a selfish node and its behavior in MANET. Here we propose a new technique named Modified Scalum Distribution Based Selfish Node Detection, that is MSD-SNDT, to detecting the selfish nodes in the mobile attack networks, that is MANET. Here main objective of our research is, our main goal of this scheme is to detect the selfish nodes effectively and then to send data packets from source node to destination node at lower cost. So we have to maximize the value of utility of the source node. The introduction about the mobile ad hoc network is a wireless ad hoc network among mobile devices. It is a self-configuring system of mobile nodes connected by wireless link, which contains a network area with nodes. This network is related to a new communication paradigm which contains a group of mobile devices communicating through a wireless medium. A major problem in MANET is the frequent occurrence of network divisions due to the unlimited movement of the mobile nodes in the network. Each mobile node in MANET requires the help of other nodes to forward the packets. The nodes are expected to wait for a predefined time interval between successive transmissions, but a mobile node may misbehave due to network congestion and selfishness. Misbehavior due to selfish or malicious reasons or faculty nodes can significantly reduce the performance of MANETs. And characteristics of ad hoc networks are nodes behavior. In MANET, every node is an autonomous node as it works both host and switch. Then multi-hop routing. Multi-hop routing is useful for particular in MANET, where if a source and destination node exchange messages and both are out of the radio range, then routing through intermediate nodes is performed. Then dynamic topology. The nodes can move in or move out the network at will, thus resulting in dynamic topology of a network. Then lighter nodes. Mobile nodes which have less computing power, energy and memory. Low capacity links. Remote nodes generally perform below averages compared with wired nodes in terms of quality, effectiveness, and steadiness of connections. This demonstrates the inconsistent bandwidth of remote links. Then what is a selfish node? A mobile ad hoc, that is MANET, is a self-configuration system comprised by multiple mobile wireless networks. The node misbehavior due to selfish reasons can significantly diminish the performance of MANET. A selfish node attempt to use the resources only for its own purpose, and it hesitate to share the resources with their neighbor nodes. So it is very important to detect the selfish node to improve the performance of MANET. We define a node as selfish if the node wants to gain packet forwarding services from other nodes but avoids rendering the same services to other nodes. Note that selfish node is different from the malicious node. A selfish node is just not cooperate, whereas malicious node intends to damage other nodes. Then node misbehavior means deviation from the original routing and forwarding. The source node can relay packets to the destination node, other node in MANET. The selfish node do not participate in the routing process, which intentionally delay and drop the packet. This misbehaviors of the selfish node will impact the efficiency, reliability, and fairness. The selfish node does not perform the process related to packet forwarding function of data packets unrelated to itself. The selfish node utilizes its limited resource only for its own purpose because of the energy and storage constraints for each node in the MANET. It aims to save its resources to the maximum, so this type of misbehaving node discards all incoming packets except those which are destined to it. The selfish node neglect to share the resources such as battery power, CPU time, and memory space to other node in MANET. This behavior is observed in the data link, or that is MAC layer, which is designed specifically when the mobile nodes possess small residual power. The features of selfish nodes are as follows: non-participating in routing, no transmission or reply to hello messages, intentional postponement of route request. Then data packet dropping. Then what is my selfish node detection? The MANET is modeled and the node in the network are deployed according to the architectural model. Numerous nodes will participate in the MANET for forwarding and transmitting the data packets between the source and destination. All the nodes in MANET perform the routing function as mandatory, and they must forward traffic which other nodes send to it. Among all the nodes, some of the nodes will behave selfishly. These type of nodes are called as selfish nodes. Any node in MANET may selfishly, which means using its limited resources only for its own profit. Since each node in a network has the resource constraints such as storage and battery limitations, This type of nodes like to enjoy the profits provided by the resources of other nodes in the network, but it should not make its own resource accessible to others. These nodes intend to get the greatest benefits from the network while trying to preserve their own resources. The behavior of selfish nodes are below. Do not forward root request message. This type of nodes does not forward the root request message in manner. It drops the packets to the avoid being the route number of others. Do not forward data message. That means this kind of selfish nodes will forward the messages but will not relay data messages and drop them. This message will impact the performance of manner. Delayed forwarding root request message. This kind of selfish node forward a message with a delay near the upper limit of timeout. Do not forward root request message. If the kind of selfish node exists in manner, it will drop all root request message received by these nodes. For example, it's one kind of our experimental result. Again, the red colors indicates the selfish nodes. Comparison with existing techniques and the trust model. In the trust model based selfish node reduction technique, its merit is trustworthiness of nodes are considered secure routing, but demerit is traffic overhead due to TRR. Then reputation management based, its merit is behavior of nodes are analyzed and demerit is approach only based on selfish nodes. Then anomaly based IDS is anomaly events are diagnosed both in accidental errors and intentional attacks. The demerits is selfish nodes refuse to run IDS. Then watchdog and path rater increase demerits transmission overhead. Then risk awareness to manet routing attack. Its merit is reduce network partitioning due to isolation of malicious nodes. Then demerit is packet overhead and buy overhead. Our proposed technique is modified scalem distribution based selfish node reduction. Here, what's the meaning of scalem? Scalem is a discrete probability distribution of the different two statistically independent random mobile nodes. Here our merit is selfish nodes are easily isolated. Behavior of nodes is analyzed in easy and a better manner. Efficiency and security increases. Our proposed technique modified scalem distribution based selfish node reduction technique. It include intention of mean packet deviation and assessment of variations and standard deviation for computing MSD and detection separation of selfish nodes. So it's a mean packet deviation. The deviation, the number of packet received to the number of packet followed by each mobile node to the neighbor as recommended through neighbor based intention each session sees. Here first we find that the deviation packet by the followed by packet received and the packet forwarded. Then next we find out the packet forwarding capability. After that we have to find the mean packet deviation. Then next we have to calculate the variance and standard deviation of modified scalem distribution. Then finally we compiled the algorithm modified scalem distribution. These are the proposed algorithm. Let n be the number of nodes and gn be the group nodes. Set of nodes and routing path can be set up as request message. So then mobile node react to the source node by route request. Let this algorithm step 6 to 14 we can execute node. Then which has place with the round down. Then that utilizes the number of session of transmission and forward each node k for group node in the route pathing. Then determine deviation utilizing condition 1. Then compute packet forwarding by equation 2. Then calculate mean deviation using equation 3. Using equation 4 and 5. Then after that compute MSD using utilizing equation 6. Here we can set the threshold value less than 0.35. Then node k is a selfish node misbehave. Then after that we have to find out. It's a flow diagram. First sending data between nodes, then selfish algorithm detect the selfish node. Then path has been, after detecting the selfish node, the path has been changed. Then transmission occur without delay. Then our simulation result, the superior role of the proposed MSD SNDT scheme is invested by using simulation experiment conducted by using a network simulator tool 2.32. We simulate a network with a field size of 500 meter and 500 with 20 nodes. In our simulation, the pause time we will set 0.3 seconds. The communication patterns which we'll use will have constant bit rate, that is CBR connection with the data rate of 3 packets per second. 20 connection will establish at random so that each node can change to connect every node. We will simulate our system using two configurations of selfish, that is for selfish node. Then second is no selfish node. For no selfish node, we can create a simulation time is 100 seconds and mobile nodes 20. Here we can not given selfish node. Number of selfish node here is 0. Then setting the time of z is 3, then maximum speed is 20. Here we are setting the selfish node as number of selfish node as 4. So it's the execution of animator with 20 nodes. Then it's no transmitting packets in the network. The next, here there is no selfish node. Here the red color indicates there is packet 0, 4, 7. These are the selfish nodes. Then we have some plots, performance of throughput different mobile nodes, then performance control over overhead mobile nodes, then over different nodes, the next packet latency, then throughput, then control overhead by proposed algorithm. Then we compare with the different selfish nodes, then performance of packet latency with the different selfish nodes. The conclusion of our research paper is this misbehavior of selfish node is a major problem in mobile ad hoc network. The selfish nodes do not participate in the routing process, which intentionally delay and drop the packets. These misbehavior of the selfish nodes will impact the efficiency, reliability, and fairness. The selfish node utilizes the resources for its own purpose, and it neglects to share the resource to other nodes. So it is important to detect the selfish node in manner. A new technique, namely modified scalum distribution selfish node detection technique, that is shortly MSD SNDT, to detect the selfish node in an efficient manner. The suggested algorithm is an efficient method which enhances the performance of MANET. It significantly improves the performance matrices. Moreover, it diminishes the overhead latency and packet dropping ratio. In future, enhancement can be done by providing the security to the neighbor node. This avoids the neighbor node being comprised by the selfish node. These are our references.
Thank you, Ramesh sir, for presenting and participating in our conference.
Thank you.
Now I request Anand sir to ask some question or give suggestions. Over to Anand sir.
I think Girdhar sir is ready with his questions. Dr. Girdhar sir?
Anand sir?
Okay, fine. Okay, right. So, with regards to this project, I just want to know the parameters which you have evaluated. What are the
parameters? We are using simulator tool NS2 version 2.32.
Okay.
Here we can setting the mobile nodes number of 20 and assigning a selfish node as 4. Then here we are using a routing protocol DSR. And traffic is the constant bit rate, sir. Pause time is 0.3 milliseconds and maximum speed is 20 milliseconds, sir.
Okay, what are the existing technologies that you have compared with this project?
So again, getting some merits and demerits of our proposed existing techniques are trust modeling based, the next reputation management based, then anomaly based ideas, then watchdog and path rate, and risk awareness to manage routing attacks.
Okay, with regards to the previous slide, risk awareness to manage routing attack. Okay.
Yeah.
To what level does it reduces the packet overhead?
Pardon, sir?
To what level does it reduces the packet overhead? Going to say it is as a demerit.
A demerit is a packet overhead.
Okay, packet overhead. To what extent does it has the packet overhead? What is the extent of the packet overhead of this approach?
In their existing techniques.
Yes. How far your proposed system is going to overcome this demerit?
Till we can't complete our proposed methods, sir. Up to now we have find out the selfish nodes. My research is now out to we complete selfish node only detection. That's all I mentioned, sir, here.
How do you say that packet overhead is a demerit? Are you getting my question? Suppose if you say something that's a disadvantage with the existing system, it should have a value, and the proposed system it has this value and it overcomes the present method. So how do you say this one has a deep merit?
I will study and tell you, sir. But in our conclusion, I mentioned the future enhancement now is process going on can be done by providing the security to the neighbor nodes also, sir.
Sir, future enhancement is the future enhancement of this project.
Yeah.
The enhancement what we are going to do after the completion of this project.
Yeah, after the completion of the project, we will go for security also, sir.
Yes. I'm talking about the present project.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, sir. Next I call upon next presenter Muhammad Shahid Afridi P, and the paper name is Real Time Facial Recognized Attendance Using Deep Learning, and the paper ID is ICPRAM11. Over to Afridi. You can share you can share your PPTs. Yes, you can continue, Afridi sir.
Yes. Sir, I'm audible, sir.
Yeah, continue, sir, please.
A warm good afternoon to everyone. I am Shahid, and this is my team, Manish, Naveen Kumar, Pardeen, and Dr. Sapna Kulkarni, ma'am, who is an associate professor in RYM Engineering College. We are final year student, and we are doing this project called Real-Time Facial Recognized Attendance Using Deep Learning. We are living in a 21st century where everything around us has become dependent upon technology to make our life much easier. As technology is increasing day by day, but the process of recording attendance at the schools, colleges, universities, offices is still manual. Yes, some of the offices use biometric fingerprint scanner, but let's fall forward. In schools and universities, go through manual attendance sheet and sign papers to record attendance. This is slow, inefficient, and time consuming. Hence, we came up with this project that automates the process of recording, tracking attendance through facial recognition technology using surveillance camera. Facial recognize is widely used in different areas such as universities, banks, airports, and military, etc. We'll be using deep learning techniques to detect, recognize, and capture faces. Using deep learning technique, we aim to provide a system that will make the attendance process faster and more precise. Now, what is this deep learning? Why it is so popular? In simple layman's language, I can say that deep learning enables a system to think like a human brain. Before explaining this below diagram, let's understand how human brain makes decisions. Let's talk about neuroscience. By just taking small example, now I'm sitting in front of a laptop. How am I able to say this is a laptop? I can say this as a television, tablet, or anything else, right? Whenever I see this device in front of me, my eyes takes the input, passes the input to these billions of neurons. As you can see, the small black dots in this image, this is present in cerebellum of human brain. These neurons in the past were trained by seeing many different laptops with different angles. Hence, my brain makes a decision, this is a laptop. Same thing, the neural network works. It takes many input, passes the input to these hidden layers, which acts as neuron and then predict the output. Now, let's talk about area of problems what we are facing. As I have discussed earlier, that most of the universities, colleges, offices still uses the manual attendance system, which is quite slow. This method is not flexible because the risk of losing the attendance data is very high. If the attendance sheet is missing, the attendance will be lost. Other than that, unethical problems may be occurring, such as cheating in signatures, proxy attendance, etc. Another example is a student does not attend his classes, but his attendance form has been signed or set by some other students. We also have done a small surveillance based on our college. For example, in every period, we are taking attendance 4 to 5 minutes, depends upon the strength. For example, let's take, we have a class strength of 100. We are taking 4 to 5 minutes attendance. Let's take 5 minutes attendance in this scenario. 5 minutes, we have 7 periods the entire day. If we multiply 7 periods into 5 minutes, 35 minutes in the entire day we are just taking attendance. 35 minutes we are just taking attendance. If we multiply these 35 minutes for the 1 month for 27 days, excluding Sundays, if we multiply 27 into 35, I'm getting 945 minutes. 945 minutes in the entire month we are just taking attendance. If I divide with 945 minutes, divide by 50, 50 is the per period time interval which is given for each period. 945 minutes divided by 50, then 19 classes we are just taking attendance in the entire month. That this is a small analysis we have done based on the college attendance system. Hence we came up with this solution. Let's talk about the implementation part. In this project, for the facial recognition, we'll be using VGC16 transfer learning method, because to train a CNN model, it consumes a lot of time. Hence, to avoid this, we'll be using VGC16 transfer learning techniques. Here it consists of pre-trained weights and layers. As you can see in this image, this is a VGC16 architecture which is introduced by Simonian and Zisserman in 2014. This network consists of 3x3 convolutional layers and 2 fully connected layers with 4096 nodes, and then followed by a softmax classifier. This is the overview of the project. Here the video camera captures the video of the class or office. This project can be taken in any of the scenario, either it may be taken in the class or it may be used in the offices or anywhere. Here the video camera captures the video of the class or office. This will be our input. This input will be passed to our model as a frames, where it performs the data augmentation techniques such as performs angle, scaling, brightness, etc. This performs, and it all, this our model performs facial feature extraction and recognize the faces. And if the person is recognized, it marks his attendance as present in the database. Marks his attendance present as database and send him a text message saying that he is present, his attendance was taken and was marked as present at this specific certain time. This is the overview of the project. This is just an image of how our project works. And we have also evaluated, there are three ways of measuring accuracy of our CNN model. First thing is automated verification data set, where the during the training time, we'll be considering few images and testing our model. And the second is that manual verification data set, where we'll separately separately keeping a data set of the images of the people and performing the testing part. And finally, we'll be manually performing careful cross validation. We'll perform keeping a CV as 10 or 50 based on our requirements. We'll be performing careful cross validation, as we have seen that whenever we are our maximum accuracy we have reached is 98% and the minimum accuracy we have reached is 91%. When we perform careful cross validation, our accuracy was approximately in between 94% to 95%. This was the accuracy. Without further ado, one of my friend Manish will continue this project, my presentation. Thank you.
A warm good afternoon to everyone. I am Manish, and I would like to present objectives and benefits of our project to the organization. Coming to objectives, our objective of this project is to provide system which completely simplifies and automate the process of recording and tracking attendance through biometric technology to identify and verify a person through live surveillance. Our primary goal is to help different organizations improve and organize their process of tracking and managing individual attendance automatically. And additionally, we seek some other objectives such as providing a valuable attendance service for recording and tracking for an organization. Second objectives, reduce errors which are done through manual process in proper work. As this is automated system, it provides reliable attendance services, and increasing the quality of privacy security, where other individual cannot present himself or while they are not present at the site. Fourth objective is organization gets monthly attendance monthly attendance report of each individuals, or can provide day-to-day report of an individual. Like if we consider for an institution or school, student day-to-day report will be sent to their parents, and lecturers get a report of each individual, which help them to track individual's record easily. And fifth benefit is this objectives. This project provides flexibility where admin get an capability of editing attendance records. Next, benefits to the organizations are automated tracking system, easy to manage, and ease of integration, and it's a time saving. First benefit is it provides completely automated tracking system. As it is completely automated, it simplifies tracking, and there is no need to have personnel to monitor the system 24 hours a day. This attendance system can accurately report attendance and absence with identification process that is fast as well as accurate. Second benefit is easy to manage. Facial attendance system is fully automated, and managing the records will become much easier than the manual process, as manual process requires paperwork. For example, imagine recording the report of various crowds of 200 people, which is time consuming and difficult to manage manually, which may even lead to some manual errors. While this automated system can record the report of large crowds simultaneously without any fuss, and managing it at the same time in a well-organized manner. And fourth benefit to the organization is ease of integration. Biometric facial recognition technology can be easily programmed into your time and attendance system, where surveillance cameras are already present. Nowadays, surveillance cameras are used widely in institute, office, etc. So it is easy to integrate and implement it, and time saving. This whole system is much safer, time saving and faster method to record attendance without interrupting the ongoing work. Without further ado, my teammate Farzin will continue this presentation.
Good afternoon, I am Farzin here. And in this literature survey, a facial recognition and RFID verified attendance system, authors in reference one proposed a model of an automated attendance system. The model focuses on how the face recognition incorporated with radio frequency identification and detects the authorized student, and it designs an implementation of student attendance system using iris biometry. And in this paper, reference to author have designed and implemented an attendance system which uses iris biometry. Initially, the attendants were asked to register their details along with their unique iris template. And third one, automated attendance system using machine learning approach. In reference three, author proposed an attendance system based on the facial recognition. The algorithms like vocal zones and histogram of oriented gradients features along with support vector machine classifiers were used to implement the system, and the various real-time scenarios such as scaling, illumination, and poses was considered by the authors. Quantitatively, analysis was done on the basis of peak signal to the noise ratio, that is PSNR values, and implemented in MATLAB GUI. And next one, technology used. In this, we used the technologies for front-end is HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And for back-end, we use Python, Django, and MySQL. And we use certain packages such as TensorFlow and VGG16 and OpenCV and Fast2SMS. And hardware, and we use hardware such as HD camera and CCTV and powerful system GPUs. And these are the references we used in our presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, dear students, for participating and presenting your thought in our conference. There is a small announcement. I request all the participants, please take 10 minutes for the presentation and 2 to 3 minutes for interaction. We'll stick on this instruction. Now, over to our chairpersons.
Yes, students, your presentation is good. And your analysis on 19 classes per month and all these things are very good. But my question is, how your system will recognize the student if the student is wearing a mask during these COVID times?
Sir, we'll be performing data augmentation techniques, sir. For example, I'll be showing you a data set, sir, where we will take the student's student faces with different angles. For example, this is my image, sir, where I'll be training my model with different angles, sir. Model will not only detect using my face, sir, it recognizes all the things, sir, my hairstyle, my eyes, my ears, everything, sir. Based on it will recognize. If I'm wearing a mask, there will be a certain decrease in my accuracy, sir. That will be the drawback, sir. Everything will be training based on all the features, sir. Not only with my face, sir, with my mouth or anything else.
Fine. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Next presenter, Monica M. A review of coronavirus diseases. It's an interesting topic. 2019 COVID-19 exploration of drugs and other therapies based on machine learning. And the ID is ICPRAM12, that is 12. Welcome, Monica. And
thank you, ma'am. Very good afternoon to everyone.
You can share your PPTs, ma'am.
Good afternoon to everyone. So I am Monica. I am studying in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering in the final year. My institution name is Kaveri Institute of Technology, Mandya. So in our topic, we are mainly concentrating on how the COVID-19 has exist the world. So in before the COVID-19 arrivals, it feels like a normal day. After day by day, it becomes a few people suddenly were sick, and suddenly everyone are sick. So it happens so instantaneously. So this is called as the paradox of pandemic. And in our article, we shall analyze how the COVID-19 uses on basis of machine learning and how it can be reduced by using drugs and therapies. The exploration of coronavirus drug advancement and therapies for machine learnings, we are concentrating on some of the followings: how the machine learning used to detect a coronavirus, and also we have used a CNN based technique, so control neural network, so how it is affected to the COVID-19, and we also taken some of the samples how the coronavirus effects to the graphical way of representation, and also the efficiency, how the drugs are exposed to the world and what are all the disadvantages it can handle over, and also the drug designs laboratory, what are all the drugs they have been introduced. And we also mainly concentrate on the how the exploration of drug stages and preclinical researches, etc. So this is all about an abstract. Moving to the introduction part, so in this we are considering an early stages how the coronavirus exists. So before coming up with, so first the coronavirus was introduced in the China, Wuhan city of China. So this is called as the worldwide pandemic on 11th March 2020. So this is the novel and contagious viral phenomenon has stepped into the world in December 2019, on December 1st of 2019. So the WHO who gives us that this is one of the worldest pandemic, and how to give the efficiently get rid of this COVID-19. So this COVID-19 is the root for the SARS and ADARS. So SARS means a several accurate respiratory distress syndrome, and ADARS is the acute respiratory distress syndrome. MARS means a Middle East respiratory syndrome. So if we are considering about the COVID-19, this pandemic affects millions of people and caused many deaths in the worldwide. So the most five top affected countries is USA, Brazil, India, Russia, and Peru. So this coronavirus first came into existence with the wet markets, fresh meat, and seafoods of various animals like bats and pangolins. Genome survey shows that the coronavirus is a physical related to SARS-like bat diseases. Hence, the bats could be the feasible source of the virus's facsimile. So this coronavirus disease was recognized by the Chinese Center for the Disease Control and Prevention by the throat slab sample, and patient was later named as the COVID-19 by the World Health Organization. So, and
And also, if we are considered the manifestation can be recognized by the CT or X-ray images, means how the COVID has been affected to the peoples can be identified using the CT X-ray images. And the people affected by the other deadly diseases such as the asthma, diabetes, heart attack, or many other prontoviruses that may be causes a several illness. So if the persons are health also, but if they are suffering from these kind of diseases, they can attack the COVID-19 very easily. So the initial stages of moderate stages such as the dry cough, fatigue, sneezing, headache, loss of senses, smell, taste. So while as in several cases of shortness of breath or tiredness, so these are the some symptoms of infected peoples. So then if we are considering of drugs, means initial stages they were concentrating mainly on the hydroxychloroquine and antipyretic antiviral used to for concentrating of a treatment. And also today the machine learning mainly concentrate on, so why this machine learning came in a COVID-19 means, so why we have considered means, so the machine learning and emerging technique take part in an important role in a responsibility to the coronavirus cases for accelerating a drug research to diagnose the diseases. Even the paramedical companies have developed several vaccines or drugs that will be displayed in the next new slides, what all the drugs that have been introduced. So asymptotic infected peoples means if the peoples having the symptoms of the COVID also, they are healthy, so they, we could not find out the person having a COVID-19 or not, so that is called as the asymptotic infection peoples. So the machine learning uses a large amount of data based models for pattern recognition, explorations and predictions. Machine learning has changed the intentions of diagnosis by providing a large number of results to diseases like diabetes and epilepsies. So in our study on accessing the severity of the chest X-ray images, so we are considered the chest X-ray images, so in this we are considered the chest X-ray, so in that we can identify how the diseases has got infected to the peoples. So we are using many of the national regular agencies used to spread the clinical testing. So some of the regulations such as FDA, Food and Drug Administration, EMA is the European Medical Agencies. So before giving drug to the society, we need to get the approval from the FDA or any other EMA type of agency. So that is the European Medicine Agencies. So next, the parameters will be explained by my co-author Vidyashree.
Good afternoon, everyone. In this article, we are mainly concentrating on some of the parameters. Let us see one by one. Applying machine learning method to detect coronavirus risk. Machine learning is susceptible to key in preventing risk in different fields, mainly in healing field. There are contamination chance, seriousness chance, and result chance. These three chances are used for conducting and publishing coronavirus controls. And also, we can forecast the risk of infection. This indicates how probably a single person is keen of coronavirus. This chance of prognostication analysis is still in the processing stage of the current COVID-19 pandemic. And also forecasting who is a chance of severe case. When a person or a group of person have infected, there is a need to identify the individual or group of people for advanced medical care. There are so many symptoms like lung disorder, acute respiratory distress syndrome, etc. So it is far better to start the earlier treatment for every symptomatic infected people. We can forecast the treatment outcome. The treatment outcome of the infected patients gives us the best role in deciding the life and death of the person. As I told in the above discussion, symptoms could not decide how long a person can survive. At the end of the day, we should know that not all infected peoples are treated similarly. Come to the second parameter. I'm explaining here CNN-based techniques for identifying COVID-19. CNN is a convolution neural network. It does not require a complex feature. It can apply easily to different flexibilities such as X-ray and CT pictures. Hence, it is used to detect the symptoms of COVID patients. Here we use some of the techniques for identifying COVID-19. They are deep convolution futures research. It is a first overall study of implementation of machine learning algorithms for automated diagnosis and chest x-rays. Data set collection of x-ray and CT images. Here we collected some of the chest x-ray images of our confirmed COVID-19 patients. These are the chest x-ray images which is collected to see how the COVID patients gets affected through lungs. Coming to advanced standard, in this advanced standard, we mainly concentrate on true or false value. It is also called Boolean value functions. As the Nagbhushan sir told in the morning session about the recognition, we will be considering the four issues. They are true acceptance, true rejection, false acceptance, false rejection. As the same, we have considered as follows with true positive, true negative, false positive and false negative. Here some of the expression we use for our article. They are recall, precision, accuracy and F1 scores. These are used for our project. And next third parameter is graphical representation.
You can jump to the conclusion.
Coming to conclusion part, obviously we all know how the coronavirus has changed the world. Everything has been impacted. So in this article, we have suggested several schemes to control the current situation. By using machine learning, we are mainly concentrating on drug development and other therapies of coronavirus. Machine learning plays an important role in accelerating drugs research by using big data for pattern recognition, description and divination, and also we use main techniques such as ANN, CNN and methods like exponential growth, logistic growth and flatten the curve. Several countries were using chloroquine or hydrochloroquine for the treatment purpose. And these are the reference views.
Thank you, Monica M and team, for presenting your paper in this conference.
If any queries.
Yeah. Sir will ask. Sir, over to sir. Sir?
Yeah, Professor Anant, you don't want to ask any questions?
No, sir. You can proceed.
Thanks, Monica and Divyasri. Presentation is good. Appreciations for the final year students.
Thank you, sir.
Is it in the implementation stage or already you have implemented?
We are doing the same for final project.
Good. Okay. All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Next, we call upon our Rashmi Patil. Detection and classification of malignant melanoma using machine learning algorithm. And the ID is ICPRAM15. Over to Rashmi.
Already present.
Morning, she has presented that.
Yeah, it's okay. Yes, sir. Next, I'll call upon Saraswati Y. Saraswati Y. Survey paper on Internet of Things. And the paper ID is ICPRAM59. Saraswati ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am, I'm here.
Yeah, continue.
Okay. Ma'am, can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am, continue.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Saraswati from MTech. I have done a survey paper on IoT. Here are the table of content. Today we'll discuss about introduction, literature survey, applications, conclusion, and references.
Introduction. Sorry for the interruption. Just make a presentation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I didn't get you, sir.
Just make your presentation within 5 minutes, so that we can ask you some questions. Just make your presentation for 5 minutes.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay. Introduction. What is IoT? IoT is a network where we connect things to internet to exchange data. Here in IoT is nothing but Internet of Things, where we connect everything to the internet. That makes there will be no human intervention. It is a technique where there is no human intervention. If we connect things to internet, it becomes easy for accessing. We use different objects here to connect to internet. We like sensors, mobile phones, actuators, technologies like RFID. Here in IoT, the major issue is security reason. I in the literature survey, the first paper, the first author which I have referred is this first person, where in that he told that he have used the authentication schemas for IoT. In the for the second one, the author explained about the IoT using big data analytics. Coming to the applications, here we have applications on smart living, where smart living, remote appliances, laundry monitoring, intrusion detection systems. Remote appliances is nothing but when we can connect any applications remotely. Laundry monitoring is nothing but when we use something like a washing machine. When we want to see the operations when we are away from our house, we can use laundry monitoring system so that we can see all the operations going on. The intrusion detection system is nothing but when there is a person who is trying to enter our house. We use this system so that we'll get a notification that someone is trying to enter into our house. Coming to the next one, smart cities. This is structural health monitoring. This system is used for to check the health of the building, like whether the cement is working. Check the health of the building. Smart parking is nothing but to check where if we go to a mall, we need to park our cars. If there is no space, there will be some disturbance. So to avoid that, we use smart parking system where we can allocate the space to park our car in the free space. Next is smart environment, where we use air pollution monitoring system. Air pollution monitoring system is nothing but here we check whether the air is polluted or no. Then next comes weather control system. Weather control system is nothing but we use change in climate, change in temperature, humid, everything. Next comes smart industry. Here in smart industry we use detection of gas leakage. The detection of gas leakage is nothing but when there is some mixture of gases, if there is something like that, we use detection of gas leakage systems. Then maintenance of instruments. If there in the industries we use many different types of instruments. In that, if there is some problem in some instrument, we will get a notification of that instrument. Next is smart health monitoring system. Health monitoring system is nothing but to check the patient's condition, whether the patient is is there any fluctuations or not like that. Next is dental system. Dental system is nothing but where we use a toothbrush connected to the IoT. It gives the details about the teeth when we brush our teeth. Next is smart energy, wind turbines. It gives the output about the turbines, like how fast is rotating, like everything. Next is power supply management. Power supply management is used for power supply, where we can maintain the less usage of power, everything. It gives we can connect bulbs to the internet. Suppose if we are not in that place, we can switch off the lights. Maintaining the power. Next is smart agriculture, irrigation system. Irrigation system is nothing but can check the soil condition where there is water supply. And I think is nothing. If we
We move on to the abstract. The main purpose of this paper is to develop a prototype of the vehicle black box system. Vehicle black box system that can be installed into any vehicle all over the world. This prototype can be designed with minimum number of circuits. This system can contribute to constructing safer vehicles, improving the treatment of crash victims, helping insurance companies with their vehicle crash investigations, and enhancing road status in order to decrease the death rate. According to World Health Organization, more than a million people in the world die each every year. Like flight data records, in a black box technology can now play a key role in vehicles or the bus crash investigation. Black box is a device. It displays information related to the accident.
Your voice is not clear.
Vehicles. Correct. What?
Your voice is not clear, ma. Check your network.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Now, ma'am?
Yeah. Okay, continue.
Black box means it is a device installed in some automobiles to record information related to vehicle crashes or accident. A significant number of vehicles currently on the road contain electronic systems that record information in the event of a crash. That is why it is so important to have recorders that objectively track what goes on in vehicles before, during, and after a crash. As a complement to the subjective input that is taken usually from victims, eyewitnesses, and police reports, this system is committed mainly how to detect and record data from the vehicle. The main purpose of this paper is to develop a black box system that can be installed to any vehicle all over the world. Objectives. Ma'am, now it's audible, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. It's audible.
It is used to analyze the cause of vehicular accidents and prevent the loss of life and property arising from vehicle accidents. The system aims to achieve accident analysis by objectively tracking what occurs in vehicles. The system involves enhancement of security by preventing tampering of black box data. It detects the alcoholic person with the help of alcohol sensor. It detects the drowsiness of a person using eye blinking sensor. Literature survey. By using these papers, we implement our project. Vehicle accident prevent cum location monitoring system. Majority of road accidents occur during night driving due to the drowsiness state vehicle driver. Design and implementation of an eye-blinking detector system for automobile accident prevention. The physical condition of the driver at regular intervals during the movement of the vehicle and preventive measures are automatically taken for the safety. Major reasons of accidents: overspeeding, drunken driving, distractions to driver, red light jumping, avoiding safety gears like seat belts and helmets, non-adherence to lane driving and overtaking in a wrong manner. Existing system: manual monitoring of the vehicle. Accident prior intimation is not there. Difficult to identify the problems occur in the vehicle. There is no intimation to the hospitals and family members when accident occurs. In proposed systems, automatic monitoring of the vehicle condition and prior intimation. If accident occurs, means sent intimation message to nearest hospitals and family members with the location. Collecting evidence from the system, detection of alcohol and intimation, detection of drowsiness and intimation. When the coordinates are fed into the GPS system, we can get an exact location of the incident place. Proposed system make use of different sensors like alcohol sensor, eye blinking sensor, temperature sensor, vibration sensor to record the various driving data parameters. Design and methodology. This is continued by my project associate, Vanita.
Good afternoon, everyone. Whenever a user vehicle meets with any accident, the vibration sensor detects and gives its output. This output is then detected by microcontroller. Now, the microcontroller sends this detection signal to a GSM module. GSM module begins sending the accident data by SMS. Microcontroller. Microcontroller is a small computer on a single metal oxide semiconductor integrated circuit chip. A microcontroller contains one or more CPUs along memory and programmable input or output peripherals. Temperature sensor. It is used to measure engine temperature. Vibration sensor is used to crash or roll over a detector of the vehicle during and after a crash. It will send a signal to microcontroller, which in turn will activate GPS GSM module. Eye blinking sensor. With the help of this sensor, we prevent accidents due to drowsiness in vehicles. Alcohol sensor is used to detect alcoholic person. MEME sensor is able to store the factors such as vibration, speed, humidity, temperature, etc. And it is connected with the accelerometer. Hence, if the speed of the vehicle is at a high rate, it will give a warning alarm to the driver. RS232. It is a serial port and is a serial communication interface through which information transfers in or out sequentially, one bit at a time. Methodology. Power supply is supply of electrical power. The global positioning system is a technology which provides flexibility of positioning for navigation, surveying, and data capture. Read the data from sensors. One of the most common devices attached to a microcontroller is an LCD display. When an accident occurs, GSM will send the SMS to the owner's family and rescue team. GSM is a digital system, and over the air, microcontroller will read information and display it on the LCD display. If any accident occurs, then GSM will send it to the family and responsible authority. A memory card is solid state electronic flash memory data storage device capable of digital contents. Push buttons are used to control the some aspect part of the machine or a process. Conclusion. Our contribution is that we proposed a low power microcontroller which can be used in the hardware implementation as its main controller in the automation of this device. With the meaningful support of the embedded systems, IoT and cloud computing, we strongly believe that intelligent vehicle black box using IoT will be reliable, power efficient in the real-time applications. And this is the reference. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Shahida Begum and team, for participating and presenting your topic. Sir? Hello?
Yeah, Shahida Begum.
Yes, sir.
Have you implemented this project in your college?
Still, we are implementing, sir.
So the initial stage only. What is the cost of the hardware components that you have mentioned in your project?
$12,000, sir.
Fine. Okay, madam. We'll go for the next one.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Our next presenter, Chitra Guttal. Survey on techniques and methods on stock market prediction. And the ID is ICPRAM16, that is 60. Over to Chitra Guttal.
Hi. Good afternoon, respected sir and madam. We are here to explain about We are here to explain about the survey of techniques and methods on stock market production. Let me introduce myself, Gautami, and my friends Chitra Shri, Hiranmay, and Srileka. This is the table of contents, abstract introduction, motivation, literature survey, algorithms of stock market production, techniques of stock market production, benefits of the society, and conclusion. A stock market prediction is a forecasting, is a way of projecting the future financial markets on the basis of stock market values of the previous industries, equipments, failures available on the market. This paper we have to survey with various techniques and methods which are most essentially needed and widely used for prediction of the market. Stock market prices increases the economic growth of a developing country will be high in dealing with the ownership of a company.
Moving to the introduction, basically stocks are an equity investment that represent a part ownership in a company. Today, predicting the market value has a great importance, which will help in optimizing the profit and minimizes the risk. This is very important because you need to invest your money in a stock that will increase in value rather than decrease. The stock market and the country's growth are closely related. As if the stock price increases, the economic growth of the country also increases. And if stock market crashes, then economic growth of the country will fall down. We can predict the future value of a stock by taking previous data of that particular company and by using the various algorithms and techniques that are going to be discussed in the forthcoming slides.
Moving to the motivation, the assumption of various data is increasing more effectively in today's world, and the most important needs of today's demands in society are rising more effectively. We need to understand the different techniques and algorithms to perform prediction operations for any of the research. So we have gone through a variety of techniques and algorithms that already exist, which help us to acquire the fundamental information. This is most important for the researchers and beginners in order to establish their own models for the prediction of the market. This is why we carried out our research in this field of interest.
Literature survey. As we did a literature survey, we have come up with few of the method as follows. The first paper is optimization of stock market prediction method. Here they use recurrent neural network, long short-term memory, and support vector machine. This paper concludes that this predictive system would be performed amongst the data processing methods to get accurate model of stock. Second paper is a sentiment-based stock market prediction. Method used are SVM and simple linear regression. From this, we can conclude that higher the accuracy, more is the precision of the stock price. So this model is more efficient for the prediction accuracy.
The other paper is numerical-based attention method with real information. The method used in this task, numerical-based attention method, recurrent neural network, and mean squared error. This paper concludes that these methods effectively exploit the complementarity between mean and numerical data in the stock market. And other paper is stock volatility prediction by hybrid neural network. Some of the methods we have included is this paper says that HTPNN, hybrid time series prediction neural network, achieves superior performance in terms of balancing the prediction effect and the running time. And the main contribution of this paper is to provide the integration of advanced features and the basic stock information.
And the next paper is efficiency of mean sentiment for stock market prediction. Method used in this paper are Navier-Bayes classifier, KNN, SVM, and neural network. This model examines the effect of analyzing diverse type of stock-related news with numeric historical data on the stock market. And the last paper is a prediction approach for stock market volatility based on time series data. Method used in this paper are ARMA model, autoregression, and moving average. In various real-world problems like that of health sector, education, finance, and other practical domains for prediction. This model introduces the concept of time series analysis and forecast the economy.
Now let's discuss about the various algorithms used for stock market prediction. The first algorithm is linear regression. It is the most commonly used and interesting predictive technique which predicts a numerical value. This algorithm is a supervised learning technique that is used to calculate the mapping function to get the best predictions. The relationship between two variables, that is dependent and independent variable, is known as linear regression. In this, we can predict the output of the
dependent variable based on independent. The major advantage of using the linear regression model is linearity. It makes the estimation procedure simple and equations are easy to understand on a modular level.
Another algorithm is KNN, that is chain nearest neighbor algorithm. The classification and the regression problems are usually solved using this simple and supervised KNN algorithm. KNN algorithm stores all the available data and classifies the new data points based on similarity. Then it will further classify the new data appears into a well suitable category. The process price for the stock market prediction can be computed by determining the nearest neighbor, that is K number, followed by computing the regression. And after sorting all the training records, finally the majority of the class labels and the nearest neighbor is aware of the prediction value for the query record.
Dear participant, there is a lot of noise. Hello? Yes. Hello? It's disturbing a lot. There is a lot of noise behind you. Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, continue, ma'am. Okay. There is a lot of noise, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, continue. See there again.
And the next algorithm is support vector machine. It is a supervised machine learning algorithm which can be used for both classification or regression. It is mostly used in classification problems. The primary goal of SVM is to find the optimal hyperplane that divides the data points linearly into two components by maximizing the margin. SVM can solve linear and non-linear problems and work well for many practical problems. Here's how a support vector machine algorithm model works. First, it defines lines or boundaries that identify the training dataset correctly. It then chooses the one with the maximum distance from the nearest data point from certain lines and boundaries.
Next, we move on to the decision tree. We use a decision tree algorithm called CERT algorithm. Stands for classification and regression tree algorithm. Some of the decision tree terminologies, all right, first being the Gini index. It is the measure of impurity or purity used in the measure of building a decision tree in CART algorithm. Next is the information gain. The information gain is the decrease in entropy after dataset is split on the basis of an attribute, while constructing a decision tree is all about the finding an attribute that returns the highest information gain. Well, next is the reduction variance. It is an algorithm used for continuous target variable or to solve the regression problems. Next is the t-square. The t-square, it is an algorithm which is used to find out the statistical significances between the difference of the subnodes and the parent node. The decision tree is one of the more widely used classifier practice because the algorithm creates rules which are easy to understand and interpret.
Moving to the techniques used for stock market prediction, the first one is regression technique. It is an analytical method that determines the relation between different variables for predicting purposes. The regression analysis is used because it allows you to make better decisions for your business currently and into the future. This approach is used for predicting modeling time series and involves determining the best fit line, which is a line that passes through all the data points in such a way that distance from the each data point is minimized. Using this technique, we can predict the company's future prices based on present and previous data.
The other technique is LSTM, long short-term memory. LSTM networks are a type of recurrent neural networks capable of learning order dependence in sequence prediction problems. These networks are well suited for classifying, processing, and making predictions based on time series data. This memory cell has the ability to encapsulate the notion of forgetting part of its previous store memory as well as to add part of the new information. The success of LSTM is in their trying to be one of the first to implement and overcome the technical problems and deliver on the promise of recurrent neural networks.
And the next technique is nonlinear regression. Nonlinear regression is a relationship between an independent variable and a dependent variable, which results in a nonlinear function model data. Nonlinear regression is one of the familiar models for predicting the upcoming values of variable based on multiple independent variable relationships. Nonlinear data modeling is a standard activity in data science and analytics. It is extremely difficult to find a natural process whose result differs linearly from an independent variable. Nonlinear model of regression are used since they can handle various mean functions.
Final is the classification technique. In machine learning, classification is a type of supervised learning approach in which the computer program learns from the input data and then uses the learning to classify the observations. Classification is a well-known machine learning technique which solves a problem by managing the missing data.
One of the most important factors is benefits to the society. The main benefit of stock prediction is easy to buy and even easy to sell. This prediction offers the chances of huge profit. Prediction allows the right stock market to move in the right direction for trading purposes. Here we can see the window which shows the possible benefits that one can derive with the help of automated software. The software can reduce the biases, it cross-checks the results and schedules the tasks without any delay, and consistency is assured and convenience of results is must. Therefore, this software guides the stock market decision is good enough.
The goal of our research study aims to support stockbrokers and shareholders with the capital in the stock market. Our research paper aims to assist stockbrokers and investors through the funds in the stock market. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, participating and presenting. Please unmute your voice, participant. Hello, Gautami.
Yes, ma'am.
Mute your voice, please. Thank you, students, for participating and presenting your topic in the conference. I request once again, please, participants, brief out your presentation and try to finish up within the given timeline. Thank you. Now, over to Sir. Giridhar, sir.
Yeah, students, your literature survey is good. You have referred so many papers and you can put some statistic and analysis on stock market prediction. That should be good for your presentation. And what is the mapping function used in linear regression? You have mentioned that there is a mapping function which can have the best predictions in the linear regression.
So using linear regression is a predicting technique, we can predict the dependent variables through that it forms a linear graph. So through that we can predict the share prices and we can say whether it increases or decreases.
Good. Do you have good analysis on these algorithms? You have mentioned many algorithms for stock market prediction.
Sir?
Right, madam. We'll move to the next paper. You please ask Anant. Professor Anant is there. Want to ask any questions?
No, sir. We can proceed.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Now I call upon Manjula SD on the topic of